crypto interchangeably. Mm. And to me, that seems like a mistake, because Bitcoin seems to have gotten caught up in the whole mania, the bubble issue, whereas crypto, the idea of mediums of exchange, is something that is a different issue.
Well, as we think about the asset class, we really do think about it as a whole re-architecture of the financial system, where you'll have currencies, you'll have commodities, digital resource tokens, which could provision things like file storage or computing power, scarce digital resources of real economic value. And then finally, you have actual securities that are just issued on top of this new technology.
And that's starting to happen, right? People are looking at putting credit markets in particular on crypto.
Exactly. Yeah, and so I think if you look at the fundamentals, dating back the past few years, Bitcoin may be one of the healthiest right now, just because it's the longest dated. It's been around for almost 10 years. It's been through these cycles before, where you want to actually do a little bit more diligence and deep dives, both in technically and in terms of the economics of these systems, is in the longer tail of assets. Which of these are going to come out the other side intact, and which are on a slow and steady march down to zero?
Thoughts? I mean, when you look around, you mentioned the Bloomberg Galaxy Crypto Index, signs of institutionalization of the space. I mean, price and indices are sort of key to everything. Do you get interest from people in sort of some of the more tertiary coins, or for now, do people just sort of care about the price of Bitcoin?
It's kind of shocking the amount of interest I get from people who want to provide data and information. Mm. And to me, that's an indication that it just needs a good gleaning. We need to, more of what we're seeing this year. We need some of these peripheral coins that, you know, so the total on coinmarketcap.com is over 2,000. That probably needs to drop by 50%. And if you look at just the top 10.
That's conservative.
Well, exactly. So you look at the top 10, the best performing in terms of capitalization this year is Tether. It's a stable coin. To me, that's where, if it's a currency, that's where we need to go, to stabilization. Now, I do believe Bitcoin is a good value for digital gold, but it's still way too volatile.
When it comes to stable coins, this is something that's certainly been a theme of 2018. It feels like we started with Tether, but now we do have some more coming to the fore, the likes of what Circle has launched, for example, which is a Boston-based company. Are you starting to see, Ryan, stable coins doing what they should do, what they're meant to do? Are they going to help evolve the space?
Well, I think stable coins, at least some of the ones that you mentioned, are certainly good for inter-exchange liquidity and allowing trading between some of these different global organizations. But if you think about it, the solutions from Paxos, from Circle and Coinbase in USDC, they are really centralized stable coins. So what actual difference do you have between a centrally managed digital currency that's fully reserved and something like Bitcoin? The similarities are few and far between. One stablecoin project that is fairly interesting, and that's held its peg despite being collateralized with Ether, which is down 90%+, is Maker. And their DAI currency, which is actually powering a lot of the decentralized applications that are actually starting to get experimented with. Very, very small volumes, but I agree that you do need that backbone for any of these censorship-resistant applications to ultimately pan out and gain any type of adoption, because no one wants to play with an asset that's going to move 50%.
Mike, you've just been in Argentina.
So did you bring up a good point? And there has to be these stable coins like Tether, and I know Gemini and other asset-backed securities. And this infrastructure that's being built out is really important for the next bull run. And if you've watched a previous video, the prediction that some of these analysts have been making, which I do kind of agree, is that we're not going to really see a bull run, and maybe you should keep away from cryptocurrencies until we do have a flatline period. And it kind of looks at it, if you look at this year graph, that it has been stable, but obviously in a bear trend. But once this trend is broken and we finally see some consistent and solid growth, then it might be a good time to get in. Until then, if you are buying into crypto at these levels, you are going to want to be able to hold for at least a year, if not a couple of years, because a lot of regulations are still waiting to be passed and a lot of infrastructure is being built into the system. But let me know what you guys think about this, and I will talk to you soon.